We're going to use equations to solve a real-life problem. Let's just read the problem here. It says that the record low temperature in Arizona is 1.6 times the record low temperature in Rhode Island. What is the record low temperature in Rhode Island? So I see that there is an image to the left side, and it shows the record low temperature in Arizona. So how can we turn all these words into an equation? Let's first of all identify the important things, okay? The record low in Arizona obviously is something important, and there's a word in there that we can use that translates to an equal sign, and that's the word is. So is, you know, after all, it means equals. So, you know, if somebody were to ask you your age, you would say my age is 13, so your age equals 13, you know, as an example. So you write down these words here, all the important things, and then you write the numbers and the values associated with them. So the record low is negative 40, is equals 1.6 times the record low in Rhode Island. So we don't know what that is. Let that be the variable. Okay, so there's our equation. Negative 40 is 1.6 times the unknown, or negative 40 equals 1.6x. So the coefficient here is 1.6, as I'm pointing out. Okay, 1.6 times the variable. And so since that is the coefficient and we're multiplying, we want to divide by the coefficient. Okay, 1.6 on both sides. So that's going to isolate our variable and get x by itself. In other words, solve the problem. So we're going to do the math. Negative 40 divided by 1.6, and we come out with negative 25. And that is our solution for the unknown variable. So we've essentially answered the problem. Go back and look. You know, they asked us originally, what is the record low temperature in Rhode Island? You know, sometimes it's easy to forget what exactly we're trying to figure out. Being as we solved for x as negative 25, there is the answer to that question. The record low in Rhode Island is negative 25 degrees Fahrenheit. And so there you have it. The secret vocabulary word here is going to be the y-axis.